Now, the second in our series on big economic troubles in Europe. Tonight, our economics correspondent Paul Solman looks at how Greek citizens are reacting to ways of dealing with the debt burden. Paul's series is part of his ongoing reporting on making sense of financial news.
Greece, still here. Tourists still flocking. More per year than Greece has citizens. Shops and restaurants in Athens still open and pretty pricey. Government still on duty, on guard. But Greece is now marching to different drummers. Europe and the IMF, which came to its aid with a three-year loan package on condition that Greece raise taxes and cut state salary. This month, Prime Minister George Papandreou also pushed pension reform through Parliament, raising the retirement age while reducing benefits.
These were very difficult measures. Obviously, that's why people are unhappy and feel the pain. Even though there are demonstrations, we also have large support. People understand that this is a patriotic duty, that we must move forward, change our economy, do not default, and deal with our debt.
The government boasts it's beating its IMF deficit targets, refinancing its debt at cheaper rates. But how much support for austerity is there in Greece? Will the reform succeed? Eventual default be averted? No more crisis?
All crisis.
A cab driver who asks to be called by his adopted name, Evgenios. He came from Cameroon as a student in 1973 at the end of Greece's military dictatorship, is a longtime observer of Greek society.
Do the Greek people understand that part of the fault is theirs for having spent more than they earned?
No, definitely not. It's something that you don't want to believe.
Is that why they're protesting so much?
No, the protesting is how to share the weight of the crisis.
Crisscrossing Athens, we found only disagreement over how, if at all, the government should pay back the mostly short-term money it's borrowed. Over 300 billion euros at the moment, 115% of annual Greek GDP. The debt supported the comfortable Greek lifestyle, perks for the plutocrats atop, social welfare benefits for the rest. Fully half of GDP is public spending, yet a third or more of the economy is estimated to be underground, off the books, untaxed, and thus incapable of covering the cost of government.
We hang on the balance, and we will be hanging on the balance for the next 3 years.
Economist Manos Matsaganis, who says Greece is stuck, caught between an old world mentality and the new fast-paced global economy.
Greeks have got accustomed to a level of consumption which is Northern European, combined with a business culture that is decidedly Middle Eastern, which is not really feasible, not very productive.
Not really feasible because, among other things, private sector employees are actually outnumbered by Greece's not very productive government workers.
You know, people don't turn up for work, or they turn up at 10 and they leave at 11. They go shopping, they come back. You know, they don't do, basically, they do nothing. Pay is not great, but it's secure. And I will retire at the age of 50. Fantastic.
Retire at 50?
Absolutely. Governments handed out concessions in the form of pension privileges to favor groups. First it was a military or the judiciary, then it was civil servants, then it was workers in state-owned enterprises, and this is how the system developed.
It's a system of buying off political pressure groups that the government's new reforms aim to change. But with half the workforce employed by the government, no wonder so many Greek civil servants are upset by the cuts. Among them, George Seferis and Ioanna Radeu.
There's a misimpression that all of us Greeks have been living large. But if you looked at the small salaries we've been getting, you'd see they can't be cut much further.
All we want is all the rights that we have gained through the past years, from one century now, and everything is gone with all this plan. No social security, no public sector, no nothing.
Vasilis Polymeropoulos of the Civil Service Union was defiant. We don't like this economic attitude toward life you have in America, he said. prompting the question,
how will Greece pay back its lenders unless it adopts a more American market-driven approach?
When I speak to my friends or relatives in the United States, they're always talking about how much money, how many dollars, how many houses does he earn. It's a sickness. They're always talking about how much that person is worth. He's worth $100,000, $300,000. And ultimately, it's not important because at the end of the day, however many houses you earn, you're going to end up in the same place, a meter and a half under the ground.
Meanwhile, as the economy shrinks at a projected 4% annual rate, private employment is shrinking too, and private Greek workers are also resisting.
Greece is facing something close to a social explosion.
Sotiris Panayotis prepped students for college entrance exams at a private school where three colleagues were just laid off.
All these austerity packages implemented by the government and dictated by the European Union and the IMF, it's not that simple, you know, temporary pay cuts, some 1 or 2, 3 years of difficulty. It means like being thrown back into the Stone Age in what concerns social rights.
In an immigrant section of town, more graphic instances of the toll unemployment, now near 12%, and a reduced public safety net are starting to take. Doctors of the World, or Cosmos, runs a free clinic for poor foreigners. But, says Dr. Elena Mavropoulou,
now Greek people are coming in our clinic because of they have not insurance and they have not even money to pay the little bit for the medicines. But they are obligated to come here because of the situation that is in Greece now. And I feel this. They're ashamed.
Immigrants still queue up for medications, but so do out-of-work natives like Miltos Nikas, suffering from stress-related bleeding ulcers.
The only thing that keeps me from committing suicide is my daughter and my parents. I feel like a parasite.
What do you mean you feel like a parasite?
Because there's no work. I can't offer anything to my family. I can't buy my daughter a cookie, an ice cream. I'm a nothing.
In fact, workers are being laid off, unheard of in Greece. That's what teacher Panayotis and friends were protesting.
If the schools can't afford to pay them due to the economic crisis, then isn't the school within its rights to lay people off?
The owners refer to that they have fewer students, but I think the problem is that they were teachers with dignity who demanded their rights. Job is not a privilege, it is a right.
But almost every person has said to us, the problem with Greece is we spent more than we earned for the last 20 or 30 years. And everyone having a job would be an example of that.
Yes, there is a problem with debt, but it was not ordinary working people that created the debt. The Greek government must say, no, we are not going to pay the debt.
But Theodoros Pangalos, the larger-than-life number two man in the government, says not paying, default, is the worst possible option.
This would mean poverty, real unemployment, and marginalization in the contemporary world for, let's say, 20 or 30 years. We are in a global market. We are in a global market of capital and goods. And whoever doesn't understand that doesn't live in a contemporary world.
In fact, one of Greece's problems, says economist Matsaganis, is that too many Greeks are living in the past.
I think we would be better off if we had a less illustrious history. If we were a normal country, you know, of mediocre ancestors. I think that has ruined us. It's like, you know, young offsprings of very rich, self-made people. This is us.
So you might ask, is there any hope? Government, under pressure, tries to change the system. The people resist. In fact, the best hope for reform may be dealing with the problem everyone here deplores, the endemic tax fraud that so long hobbled the Greek economy. And so, tax reform is the subject of our second report on the Greek economic crisis.